alle 10 che fino da lì. So, SSJK Eminent, Dr. Leahy, all the eminent members of IMA present over here. Friends, as was being mentioned by you, Dr. K.K. Agarwal, it's a misnomer to call me a guest. We already have chief guest amongst us, Shri J.P. Nadda ji, whom we all very highly revere. And in fact, I am part of the family, as was being rightly put by Dr. Agarwal. Dr. Agarwal has the right to also advise, to guide and warn, to caution that, look here, you have to be our representative in the ministry and sit with us once in a month. My personal association with him is, I can't recall how many years now. I think it was almost 20 years back when I was coming here. I was recalling one very foggy winter day, I think in December or January, when I was there to receive him. And we organized a joint camp, heart diabetes camp. He was also into that, and Colonel Srivastava from Malviya Nagar was there organizing diabetes camp, so he's no more amongst us. But we were into this business of, you know, having CMEs and also the public awareness camp. So we have been dealing with each other so effectively. And he's right in more ways than one. When he says that your first commitment, he's trying to, you know, retreat and trying to caution me if I have forgotten that. Look here, your first commitment is to the medical profession and to the IMA. And truly so. I think I am where I am because I belong to the medical profession. And there is an evidence. I think the kind of electoral, whatever performance I could put up, was also because of my reach as a medical professional. And also the camps, some of which I have jointly held with KK. So KK Agarwal ji, you are also contributed to my electoral performance. And therefore, certainly, as long as we are there, Dr. K. Sharma ji is there, it is true that we can, because having risen from, you know, from the grassroots and having gone through all the different stages of the medical profession and in a very tedious manner. For example, for a person like me who came from a village where the letter reached after 15 days. And when we went into a medical college in Chennai, three of us boarded the GT Express from the Delhi station and two of us have never seen a train so. The rural area. So welcome Dr. Mahesh Sharma is there. So the I'll just take 2 minutes because then I think the ceremony is to start. But these are some of the, because incidentally today we have both the professionals as well as the policy makers. Now you'll have to seriously think, why is it so that on the one hand you have huge rural areas where the patient doesn't have access even to a hospital bed. Patient doesn't have access to healthcare. I was going through the data. There are still about 6 million people who don't have, who have a 0% access to healthcare. On the other hand, you have complaints of avoidable heart bypass surgeries being done. So where is the meeting ground? And then we have to ask ourselves, why is this happening? It's happening because if I start a nursing home and I, you know, engage all kind of paraphernalia infrastructure. Now in order to survive, I have to have patients. My client, my customer is a patient. So, there may be inadvertently some unwanted procedures also going on. The same procedures which are sometimes perhaps without
the great organization of ours, Indian Medical Association. And of course, the noble profession of which we feel proud to be a part of. God has given us this responsibility by becoming in this profession to alleviate the agony of someone. And of course, if we can potentiate his efforts to give life to someone, he has made us the partner. which normally he doesn't mix. I think we are the proud professionals of this great profession of medicine, doctors. We are really proud of being a doctor. On the stage, the stalwarts of our medical faculty sitting, Dr. K.K. Agarwal, who is my guru in my schools. And now you can think that the guru can be there, the student will be where. Dr. Vinay Agarwal, who is really a stalwart of our profession. Dr. Lekhi, Dr. S.S. Agarwal, who hails from Rajasthan, my birthplace. And he has done a lot to this medical profession, medical tourism. All kudos to him to take the reins of this great organization for the coming years. Of our national president, Dr. Pillai, and other people sitting over here. My senior fellow colleague in the cabinet, who is really guiding the prime ministers, you can catch hold of him. About the health policies, you can really catch hold of him. And when Dr. Shri Jagat Prasad Nadhaji became the cabinet minister, I requested him that you take me with you as a deputy minister or a state minister. I'll try to help you out. But he left me in the way. और मेरी अंडरस्टैंडिंग सच बता रहा हूँ नड्डा साहब से ये थी कि मैंने कहा आप कैबिनेट मिनिस्ट्री और मुझे अपना राज्य मंत्री बना लेना, मैं आपका बाबू बन के अपनी हेल्थ किसी लोगों के साथ कुछ ना कुछ देश के लिए करने का प्रयास करूँ। लेकिन उन्होंने मुझे दूसरे फील्ड में भेज दिया, उन्होंने कहा चलो तुम मेडिकल टूरिज्म पर काम करो, कोई बात नहीं। और अच्छी बात है कि गवर्नमेंट हैज फॉर्म्ड अ नेशनल मेडिकल एंड वेलनेस टूरिज्म बोर्ड जस्ट रिसेंटली, ऑफ कोर्स very few professionals of that organizations, Dr. S.S. Agarwal, Dr. K.K. Agarwal, Dr. Vinay Agarwal, Dr. Naresh Trehan, Dr. Devi Shetty. They are the first founder member of that great organization, including the Ayurvedics and Unanis of that field also. It's a matter of pride that the Government of India has selected the few names which I have mentioned before you. And understanding the potential of this profession in bringing the tourism to this country. Our country has got a lot of potential towards, if we talk of the tourism as a whole and as medical tourism or wellness tourism or health tourism, whatever we name it. We share only 0.68% of the world tourism. And the amount of foreign revenue, foreign earnings, that is 1,23,000 crores rupees worth of foreign revenue we earn from tourism part, of which tourism, health tourism could be a greatest inspirer in that, because we have the maximum potential of medical tourism in our country. If in a European country, be it the National Health Scheme, be it the American Central Health Scheme, if we the Indian doctors withdraw today, their schemes are going to collapse tomorrow. That is the situation, that how much they are dependent on the doctors, Indian doctors over there. They are doing wonder works over there. The same doctors are available here. We have now the best of infrastructures. We have now best the machines. And we are practically providing this medical services just at the even 1/6 cost of the what is being done over there. And that without zero waiting time. If you want a knee transplant tomorrow morning, or maybe tomorrow afternoon, evening, our PSC people will clear it today night and tomorrow the patient will be on the operation table. That is possible in India only. Not possible there in any part of the world. That is our strength. Let's explore this strength. I invite you people to send even some few names, those who want to work in this field of health or medical or wellness tourism, be it any of the specialties of the medicine. Friends, I have nicely practiced some 25 good years of my profession as a doctor professional. And I really enjoyed it. With just a small saving, I was invited to deliver a talk at Kyoto. I asked them, when there are so stalwarts in medical profession, why did you invite a small person like me? So I asked them, what were the reasons of inviting me? There was a column which they asked me to pull up, that what was your seed capital when you started your medical profession. I sent Ivan Aras in house job, I got an area of 600 rupees. So they asked, what was the seed capital? I started writing 600 rupees. End of the day, it was written right in US dollars. So that poor 600 rupees got converted into some $10 or so. So they said, we wanted to know whether an Indian doctor can do something with 10 US dollars also. Yes, an Indian doctor can do this, and that is our strength. Friends, what we need today, some 25 years, Dr. Rai, Dr. Chaturvedi, the stalwarts sitting over there, when we used to feel the pulse and diagnose on the face value of the patients. And there was no Consumer Protection Act. Believe it, for 25 years of my professional career, I did not get even a single court case done against me. Single court, Dr. Chaturvedi is a witness to that, not even a single court case. If somebody has got some grudge, we used to settle it out there itself. What we have lost in this reign is, कि वो पुराने जमाने के अगर हम वैद्य को याद करें तो जब वो घर में घुसता था तो पल्स पर हाथ रखने से पहले ये पूछता था कि घर की बूढ़ी माँ जिंदा है कि चली गई, बेटी की शादी हो गई कि नहीं हो गई, शादी हो गई तो अपने घर में खुश है कि नहीं है। हम भी उस दौर से कुछ थोड़ा सा पीछे हट गए, जो इमोशनल और सोशल मैनेजमेंट ऑफ ए पेशेंट विच वॉज very important tool what the God has given us, and especially in the Indian traditions and all those things. Aur banduk ki nok par ishq nahi hua karta. Jab Consumer Protection Act jaise talwar hamare gardan par latak rahi ho, bahar clinic ke, hospital ke, nursing home ke, ambulance chasers, vakilon ki qatar bahar khadi ho, to usme emotional attachment hokar hum apne patient ke liye kya kar payenge, ye ek sochne ka vishay hai. इसके लिए समाज भी जिम्मेदार है। और आप समझिए कि आज हम दोनों डॉक्टर बैठे हैं, नड्डा साहब हमारे बीच में, वो भी आ गए डॉक्टर, चौथाई डॉक्टर तब तक बन चुके हैं। जब मैं देखता हूं बहुत सारे जब वो पार्लियामेंट में जवाब देते हैं तो हेल्थ केयर पर उनके शब्द पूरे टेक्नोलॉजी से भरे हुए, पूरे लाइक मेडिकल प्रोफेशनल ही उनके जवाब होते हैं। और मैं समझता हूं कि अब ये समय आ गया है कि हम इस प्रोफेशन को, हमारा प्रोफेशन एक एक्यूट फेज से गुजर रहा है, जहां पॉलिटिशियन भी आपको बाहर खड़ा होके कुछ कहना चाहता है कि डॉक्टर्स लोग शायद ये कर रहे हैं, वो कर रहे हैं। जो आपका पेशेंट होता था, जो आपको डॉक्टर साहब कहकर बस आपने जो दे दिया उसे विश्वास देकर मैं चला जाता था, अब वो जाकर नेट पर पढ़कर आपके खिलाफ कंज्यूमर प्रोटेक्शन एक्ट में जाने की तैयारी करता है। वकील आपके खिलाफ तैयार लगे हुए बैठे रहते हैं, और सोसाइटी में रात को 2 बजे उठ के अगर आप जाओ डॉक्टर, इसकी कीमत कोई नहीं समझता। मैं नड्डा साहब की नॉलेज में, वैसे तो है उनकी नॉलेज में ये, सर अगर आज हमारे 350 के करीबन मेडिकल कॉलेजेस हैं प्राइवेट और गवर्नमेंट मिलाकर, अगर इनकी संख्या हम दुगनी कर दें आज, जब भी संभव नहीं है, तो शायद अगले 20 साल के अंदर हम अपनी जो कमियां हैं मेडिकल प्रोफेशनल की वो पूरी कर पाएंगे। और जब मेडिकल प्रोफेशनल्स की इतनी एक्यूट कमी है, आज देश में 4 लाख डॉक्टर्स की कमी है, 9 लाख नर्सेस प्रोफेशनल्स की कमी है, पैरामेडिकल स्टाफ की कमी है, उन सर्विसेज के अंदर एनएपीएच जैसे गाइडलाइंस, जॉइंट जेसीए जैसी गाइडलाइंस के साथ, और किस तरह के रिस्क लेकर, मुझे ध्यान है आज से 20 साल पहले जब मैं अपने स्कूटर पर अपने बैरालगंज का इंजेक्शन और आईवी सिरिंज साथ लेकर चल देता था, और घर पर जाकर होम विजिट के 15 रुपए से 25 रुपए मिलते थे, लेकिन वो समय बदल गया है। आज हम सब लोगों को अपनी ऐसी ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस के माध्यम से अपनी गाइडलाइंस, अपनी मान्यताएं, अपनी वैल्यूज, अपने इस प्रोफेशन की नोबिलिटी, इन सबको आज हमें प्रिजर्व करते हुए आगे बढ़ना है, और इस पेशे की सेंक्टिटी को भी बनाए रखना है, ये भी आज की हमारी जरूरत है। लेकिन उसके लिए हमारी सबसे बड़ी ताकत है हमारी यूनिटी, हमारी एकता, हमारी एसोसिएशन, और इन एसोसिएशन के माध्यम से जो कुछ अमृत निकले उस अमृत के एक चम्मच हम जरूर पी लिया करें। और आपके लोगों की इतनी बड़ी संख्या में उपस्थिति देखकर आज पूरे देश के कोने कोने से लोग यहां पर एकत्रित हैं, हमारे प्रोफेशन के लोग, हम सब लोग, मैं और डॉक्टर जितेंद्र जी और नड्डा साहब भी, हम आपको ये विश्वास दिलाते हैं कि हम आपके बीच के प्रोफेशनल है। पहले मुझे खुशी होती है आज अपने प्रोफेशनल्स के बीच में होते हुए, कि अगर मैं इस राजनीति में भी जहां हूं अगर उसमें से मेरा डॉक्टर शब्द निकाल दो तो मैं आधा रह जाऊंगा। मुझे उस सामाजिक जीवन में, मुझे जिस राजनीतिक जीवन में जाने में इस चिकित्सा पेशे ने, इस मेडिकल प्रोफेशन ने कितनी मदद की है मैं इनको शब्दों में बखान नहीं कर सकता। और मैं समझता हूं कि आप सब लोग अपना हक समझकर, हम चिकित्सक बंधुओं से, नड्डा साहब भी आपके बीच के हैं, हम किस तरह इस अपने नोबल प्रोफेशन की गरिमाओं को सम्मान दे सके, अक्षुण रख सके, अपनी इस ग्रेट ऑर्गेनाइजेशन इंडियन मेडिकल एसोसिएशन के प्रति हम किस तरह से खड़े हो सके और अपने पेशे से जुड़ी हुई जो दिक्कतें, जो छोटा सा जो चर्चा हमने आज की है, इनको साथ लेकर हम किस तरह आगे बढ़ सके, मैं समझता हूँ ये हमारी आने वाले समय की चिंता होगी। और आज की ऐसी कॉन्फ्रेंसेज और डेलिब्रेशन से इस विषय पर हम चिंता करते रहते हैं, आगे भी करते रहेंगे और पुनः अपने आप को अपनी इस ग्रेट ऑर्गेनाइजेशन से प्रतिबद्ध करते हुए, अपने इस नोबल प्रोफेशन से अटैच प्रतिबद्ध करते हुए मैं पुनः आपसे, आपके सामने अपने आप को समर्पित करता हूं कि मैं एक प्रोफेशनल के नाते, आपका चिकित्सक पेशा बंधु होते के नाते आपके साथ में हर वक्त खड़ा हूं, इसमें कोई दो राय नहीं। बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद।
Now it's time for the D movement for which we have collected. एक छोटी सी रिक्वेस्ट, जैसे ही हमारे प्रेसिडेंट का इंस्टॉलेशन होगा, we will have a clapping, but his felicitation function we will do after Nataji speaks. So let's not have. So I request our national president Dr. Martin Bille to exchange the medallion with our incoming Amita and Dr. S.S. Agarwal and then exchange the seats with each other. And I request Nataji to please.